Hello YouTube and welcome to the second video tutorial about Anatella. I am Frank van den Bergen, CEO of Timi. In the previous video, we introduced Anatella and we saw how to install it on a machine. This video is about creating our first data transformation with Anatella. So, this is our first example. It's composed of five little boxes. For those that are familiar with SQL, this SQL query here describes what we want to do. More precisely, we want to analyze a small dataset, the census income dataset, that originates from the Census Bureau from the United States. It's an open source and free dataset that everybody can download and use. Each row of this dataset represents an American citizen. What we want to do is to plot a small bar chart like that, to illustrate the different education levels of the women in the United States. I need four steps to create my bar chart. First, here, I import the census income dataset inside Anatella. Second, here, I use a filter to only keep the rows from the dataset that represents women. Third, here, I look at the different education levels that are present inside the dataset, and I count how many times each education level is represented in the dataset. And the last step here is to plot a bar chart with the different counts about the different education levels. This additional optional step there is just for aesthetic reason. It's not really required to get my bar chart, but it makes the chart looks nicer. So let's begin for real. I close this PowerPoint presentation. And we'll go. Now, it's time to get our hands dirty. The first step is to create a working directory somewhere on your hard drive. This working directory will contain all the files required to run the little project that we are about to construct. A good place to put your working directory is inside your document folder, like I used here. A bad place to put your working directory is inside a Wi-Fi drive, because then all data accesses will be really slow. Here I called my working directory tuto Anatella. Next, I'll take the census income dataset. It's a standard example dataset that is always given with Timi and Anatella. If you follow the installation instruction given in the previous video, you will find your census income dataset here in the CSoft directory. You go into Timi Portable, Anatella Demo, Dataset, and you have the census income directory there. Okay. So I just copy-pasted my census income dataset inside my working directory. Now, if you install Anatella using the wizard application, you'll find the census income dataset directly inside your document folder. More precisely, it will be inside your document folder, Timi dataset. So this census income.rar dataset is actually just a simple text file where each of the columns are separated with a comma. And you can see here the first few lines of the file. You can now pause the video to copy-paste the census-income.rar file inside your own working directory and get back to the video just after. So the next step is to create our first data transformation with Anatella. Inside Anatella, all the data transformations are named graph. So let's create our first Anatella graph together. To do so, we'll go inside our working directory and right-click with your mouse on a blank white part of the File Explorer window. Let's do that. I am selecting New here, and you can see here Anatella Transformation Graph. If you can't see this entry, don't worry. You just have to run Anatella once before it appears. Also, sometimes Windows takes a little bit of time before displaying this new entry. So if you just installed Anatella, you might need to try several times, to run several times Anatella before seeing this new entry. So let's create our first graph together and give it a name, like tuto. Okay. I just press Enter and I press Enter a second time. And then you have the Anatella window that appears. The first time was to confirm the name of the graph, and the second time I press enter is to open the graph. You can now pause the video to create a new graph named Tuto and open it inside Anatella. The next step is to import our text dataset file inside Anatella. To do so, I'll just drag and drop the census-income.rar file here inside the Anatella window. And as you can see, there is a new little box that just appeared. What you can do now is just click here the output pin of the little box, and then you directly see the content of your dataset here in the data preview window. That's a pretty easy way to import a text file, don't you think? You can now pause the video to import the census-income.rar file inside Anatella. So, Anatella automatically selected for you the right little box to open your text dataset file. The same easy principles apply if you want to import anything inside Anatella. Any kind of file, for example, an Excel file, a SAS file, an XML file, a JSON file, or a GEL file, very important file. Every time that you drag a data file inside Anatella, Anatella automatically creates for you the right little box. So, now, let's talk a little about the difference between run mode, here, and connect mode, here. When you open Anatella, by default you are in run mode. In run mode, you can execute your graph by clicking the little blue dot anywhere inside the graph. Well, here there is only one box, but... In technical terms, these little blue dots are named pins. When you are in connect mode there, you can connect boxes together. Most of the time, Anatella will connect automatically all your boxes together for you. But, for example, if you drag a box like this one, you see? It didn't connect it together. So, if I want to connect it together, I'm going to connect mode. I'm clicking the output pin here, and the other input pin here, and the two boxes are connected. So you can now pause the video to connect the two boxes together. If you are not happy with an arrow, you can just select it and press the delete button or backspace button to delete it. You can also create very complex arrow shapes by clicking several times, like this thing. Okay. While drawing an arrow, if you click on the wrong position in the graph, you can always right-click to undo the last click. So now, if I right-click, I'm removing the last click. And then I'm connecting the two boxes together. This little box displays the number of rows inside the imported dataset. So let's run it. Let's switch to run mode and click the output pin of the box. There is about 200,000 rows inside the box. You can now pause the video and execute the little row counter box. You will quickly notice that when using Anatella, you are always switching from connect mode to run mode, and the other way around. So there exist two shortcuts to quickly switch from one mode to the other. You can either click the middle mouse wheel button, or you can double-click on any portion of the Anatella graph. So if I double-click here, you see I'm switching from connect mode to run mode. Congratulations on achieving your first Anatella graph! You can now proceed to the next section of this tutorial. To do so, you can click here.